Hello and welcome to my channel. Today's video is going to be a little bit different and I'm going to be going through my top 10 tips for surviving summer. So if you struggle with the heat and want some tips on maybe how to stay cooler, then do keep on watching, do subscribe, and I will get straight into the video. This is mainly like if you are going out in the summer. Obviously the main thing you can do is to stay in air conditioning. In the UK, we don't really have air conditioning in most houses. Like, it's in shops and cinemas and things like that, but it's not really in a lot of people's houses. And also in the UK, the buildings are designed to keep the heat in because we usually have like colder temperatures. So yeah, that's kind of what I'm basing this off of. Number one is stay in the shade as much as you can. I know this is probably very basic, but I always find there's such a big difference in if you're like directly in the sun. If it's cloudy and it's still hot, it doesn't feel anywhere near as bad as if it's like blue sky and sun. So definitely try and keep to the shade as much as possible. That way you're gonna feel a little bit cooler than if you were to actually stand directly in the sun. As I said, a little bit basic. I'd never understand how people can like sunbathe out in the sun, because even if I step out into it for like a minute, I'm just like melting. So yeah, that's number one. The second one is wear sunglasses and hats to keep the sun off your face. So I have two pairs of sunglasses. I have these ones. I have these, which are ridiculously huge, which I was wearing in the thumbnail. These are from Killstar. And then I also have these, which are more of like the traditional goth sunglasses, and these are from Disturbia. So these were definitely like, obviously, sunglasses are good anyway to keep the sun out your eyes, but they also like cover up a little bit of your face, especially if you get huge ones like this. And in terms of hats, obviously if you like kind of baseball hats, then go for that. But if you want to find like a really cool hat that's gonna keep the sun off your neck, keep it off your face, but still have like the goth aesthetic, I love fedora hats. Now I'd probably pick one in a different material, because this is like a kind of felt material, but I absolutely love wearing this in the summer. I kind of wear it like this, so it's kind of like round, kind of like a witchy style. But I got this one from H&M and it was about like £10. I actually had two of these and lost one at the airport and I was really sad, so I bought another one. But I will definitely be taking these on holiday. Also, if you don't want to wear like heavy makeup in the summer, or if you go on holiday, because I don't intend to do like all of this when I go on holiday to Italy. So even if you wear sunglasses, especially like this style or this style, like they're instantly gonna goth up your outfit. So not only do they protect your eyes and protect your face, but they do also add a bit of like gothicness to your look. Tip number three is factor 50 sun cream so you don't burn. This isn't really like a cooling tip, but it's more just surviving summer in general. I found this and I've used it once and so far I'm really impressed. So if you're a bit like me where you put sun cream on and instantly you feel like sweaty, sticky, uncomfortable, and you just feel like you want to go like this and not move, then maybe this will work for you too. I'm not sure the name of the brand. That's the name of it up there. I think it's a German company. I saw this in Boots, so if you have like a Boots, or I'm sure they'll do this in like other countries like America as well, but this is factor 50 plus and it just ticked all of the boxes. So it's a dry touch sun gel cream ultra light formula. So if you've got like oily skin and you don't like anything with too much hydration in, this has oil control technology, so you literally put it on and you don't feel sticky, you don't feel it like sticking to your skin, you don't feel like you can't touch anything. It's really good. It says extra water resistant, sweat resistant, which I definitely need, and anti-sand. So yeah, you do get quite a big bottle. I think I paid like £14 or £15 for this. Again, I'll be taking this on holiday with me. I was mainly looking for a sun cream that really didn't make me feel like disgustingly sticky, because that's one of the number one reasons that I don't like wearing sun cream is because of the stickiness. And I like a matte look as much as possible. And this does say, the formula also contains oil control technology with mattifying pigments that leaves an immediate dry touch finish. So that's what I was looking for, and that's what I managed to find this year. So I would recommend this if you're kind of the same as me, because it is actually mattifying, which is nice. So yeah, definitely sun cream. And also with factor 50, it's gonna like stay on longer than if you go for a lower factor. And I've always found that when I wear factor 50, touch wood, that I don't typically burn. So yes, definitely this. I know in America they do like factor 100 from Neutrogena, so go for that if you want. Number four, carry a fan with you. So I usually take this one. This is one I got on holiday from Sourpuss. And it's one of these like fold out paper ones with like bats on. It's really cute. And also if you are feeling like a little bit too hot, like it folds up, you can keep it really easy in your bag and just bring it out when you feel a little bit too hot. So definitely carry a fan with you. And also if you're looking for tips for like if you're in the UK and your room is hot, then definitely get like a fan or some kind of fan that you can put water in to kind of replicate air conditioning. So yeah, definitely do that. Tip number five, wear loose lightweight clothing. So typically in the summer I either wear like shorts while I'm on holiday, or I wear really like flowy things. Like even this, it is a little bit tight, but the sleeves are kind of flowy, and even the material, like it's all very flowy. Like I don't typically wear kind of pencil dresses or skirts or anything that tight too much, but I definitely avoid that in the summer and wear kind of more like loose thin skater skirts maybe with a crop top, and try not to like overlap things. So if you're wearing a t-shirt that like is almost like a dress and then you're putting a skirt over that, like that's then two layers. Yeah, definitely try and like keep as much off of you as possible and just make sure it's like loose, no like thick heavy cotton or anything like that. Oh, I've put carry a fan with you twice. I did write these last night. I also put slash parasol. I know some people do carry parasols, so maybe if you don't have a hat or you don't like wearing a hat, then you could definitely take like an umbrella. I've seen a lot of people do that at like Disney and things like that. They take umbrellas or parasols, so that is an option if you want to carry that around with you. Personally, I've never really done that because I've always kind of stuck to hats and sunglasses and sticking to the shade, but if you are like in a lot of daylight, then you could definitely do that instead. Tip number seven is keep hydrated. Another basic one, but I think it gets really overlooked. If I talk about this water app one more time, I use a water app. It sounds sponsored, but it's really not, I wish. But yeah, I use a water app on my phone, and I literally just, you put in like your height and weight, I think, and your age, and it gives you a suggested amount of water you should be drinking each day. Mine is like 2,100 milliliters, and then you can like measure your cup. So like this, and then I know that this is 400 milliliters. So I can just add that in the app and make sure that I'm really drinking enough. I tend to overdrink in summer because I just get more thirsty than I do in the winter. And also drinking ice cold water or ice cold drinks is gonna keep your temperature down as well. So yeah, definitely keep hydrated. And also when you don't keep hydrated and you start getting really like dehydrated and hot, then that's when like heat exhaustion and all of that can kick in. So definitely stay hydrated. Tip number eight is carry a cooling spray or water mist with you. So I used to get a cooling mist from Superdrug, I remember, when I last went on holiday. They are very good. They do run out quite quick, and I believe they're like £4 a can. So that can get a little bit expensive over time. You could do that if you're like out for the day, or I use one of these. I use this in the house as well, but it's just like a travel spray bottle, and I fill it up with ice cold water. You could even, if you've got like small enough ice cubes, put ice in here and then just carry it in your bag, and then if you get a bit too hot, like spray like your legs and like your neck and things like that with this, even your face to be honest, and this will cool you down for a little bit. Something that I also found out is if you've got like a fan at home, if you spray this on you and then go and stand in front of the fan, that will like make the air cooler, if the water's like really cold. So that's another tip if you're in the house and your room is really hot, then you could do that as well. That's definitely something I've been doing in the heat wave. I also kind of just ended up hugging an ice pack for 2 days as well, so there is that. Tip number 9, wear fishnet tights for airflow. So this is kind of, I mean, it depends on the person. Usually when it gets up to around kind of 30 degrees or late 20s, I believe 30 is 90, I think, in Fahrenheit, I could be wrong. But when it kind of gets to mid 80s to 100, I don't tend to wear tights. I prefer to wear tights. I probably feel more comfortable in tights, but it's just way too hot at that point. But when it's kind of in like the mid 20s, where it's a little bit hot but not like 30 degrees hot, then I do wear fishnet tights. I'm literally wearing some right now. Don't know if you can see. Yeah, I definitely find that, I don't know, it just adds a little bit of detail to an outfit, especially because this dress is quite plain, but it still allows like the breeze to like hit your legs. So it's kind of like you're not wearing tights. It doesn't feel like I'm wearing tights, to be honest. So if you are maybe a bit uncomfortable with having your legs out, or you just prefer wearing tights, then definitely get like the fishnet tights with like the bigger holes compared to the smaller ones, because that way you can still get the air, but you still get the detail on your outfit. And the final tip is a little bit general, but it says keep your head and feet cool. So I heard, I mean, my dad told me, but I think he heard it from like people in the army or something, but apparently your head and feet get the most hot like quickly, and I can definitely, like, my feet definitely get very, very hot. So maybe every so often, like, run, and this is if you're home, like, run your feet maybe under a cold tap, or have like a flannel around your neck with ice cold water or something. I'm not sure how this would kind of go if you're out in the day. You can't just like run your feet underwater, but yeah, definitely wear like a hat to keep the heat off your head directly, and maybe wear shoes that again allow more airflow. Although I absolutely love boots, especially if it gets to like the 30 degree weather, I definitely stop wearing boots. I wouldn't attempt my new rock boots in that weather, and I tend to wear more of my fabric shoes, like my hot chocolate design shoes. So maybe swap out your footwear for things like that, sandals if you like them. I don't, but that's a good option if you do like them. So maybe wear more like open shoes, or like flat shoes, fabric shoes, kind of things like that, to keep your feet as cool as possible. The last one I'll say is, because especially when I go on holiday, I tend to wear more like basic outfits. Like, although this one is a little bit simple, a lot of my outfits that I wear are like velvet, lace, they have a lot of detail, which obviously is way too much for the summer. So I definitely will say like accessorize, like have things in your hair if you want to, jewellery, things like that. I don't tend to wear this on holiday, but I definitely have like all of my rings, all of my bracelets and stuff. You could wear like really cute frilly socks. That's literally a staple for me in the summer, like fishnets and frilly socks. So there's definitely things you can do to accessorize your outfit, even if your outfit is a little bit more simple in the summer than what you'd normally wear in the rest of the year. So I do hope that these tips were helpful. I'm sure a lot of you probably knew a few of these, but I do hope it was helpful anyway. Do let me know in the comments your tips for surviving summer. I would love to hear them. Hope you enjoyed this video. Do like and subscribe if you did, and hopefully I'll see you in my next video. Bye.